last year somebody gave me a squash with a hair. This is the things like that. You got, did you get one as well, Bradley?
Squash.
Yeah, I got a squash or something. Something like that. It's not really asking us a question. It was somebody gave us vegetables, which was weird in itself. But that's for weird questions. But having fans is very nice. It's been an honour to kind of sit here and have you guys kind of looking at us as if we're going to come out with something quite profound. If you're looking for something profound, turn off while I'm talking, because it's probably not happening to save you time. But that wasn't a sympathy thing. But
no, it was.
It's a pleasure to kind of be working on a show that generates enthusiasm. So, yay.
We could never have imagined that it would be as popular as it is. Because when we make it, it's pretty much a bubble. We're all together. We spend 8 months. We don't really do anything else. And to see so many people who love it, we can't. Wrapping your head around that is difficult and wonderful at the same time. It's amazing to be sitting in a room with so many people who love what we do. And thank you, I guess.
A question from a young lady here.
Do you enjoy dressing up and with all the whole Renaissance theme costumes?
Yes. No, it's brilliant. It's great fun. Like, you know, as actors, sort of, it's what we enjoy doing, is sort of playing, really, because that's sort of essentially what you're doing as an actor. And this job in particular is brilliant because we've got amazing costume designers. You know, we get the opportunity to come into work and dress up and play with swords and go horse riding, and you know, it's really, really is a dream job.
And if you thought the costumes couldn't get any better from last year, Charlotte Morris, who designs, has outdone herself for season two, and you will not be disappointed. Really, really terrific performance. She's amazing.
And we have a question from this young lady from.
Ooh, young lady, thank you. Some of us here are going to see Bradley tomorrow in the football match. Don't hurry, you only have to show your shorts, it's fine. I wondered whether any of the fellow cast members were going to see you too.
Well, I was going to come, but I've got to get some scripts ready for shooting on Monday.
I didn't know.
I didn't say anything to them.
Whoops.
So thanks for that.
I thought, Colin, you were going to be there with a bucket of water and a sponge. Aren't you going to be there with a bucket of water and a sponge?
No.
I was playing football once, and it was just after we finished season one, and this guy, this defender, crunched me, just tackled me quite ferociously. And it took me a while to get off the ground, and as I did, he went, "Where's Merlin now?" And I thought, this is where it begins, this is where my life.
Then I just poked out from behind the corner from there.
He then was, obliterated into a ashy tears.
But we have a question from somebody here.
Yeah, this question is for the cast. What was your favourite episode to shoot?
Mine was episode 8. With Ace the Butterfield literally getting acted on screen by 11-year-old. But it was fun, it was physical, running. I got to do so much different stuff. So for me, and it was a great story for my character. Personally, I would go for episode 8. Wardrobe episode, in case you didn't know.
I genuinely enjoyed shooting all of them, but I really enjoyed episode 10. So we got weapons. The girls got weapons. Finally. So that was great fun. More of that, please, Johnny.
I'll have a think about it.
Wrong.
Ow.
I quite enjoyed. I found it hard to separate the episodes because we filmed them like 3 at a time, so it's kind of, but I guess episode 11, where Bradley me got to have a bit of banter and have fun in the forest with a unicorn.
I really enjoyed filming 4 and 5, but I think especially episode 11, which was the maze business, just because the journey kind of the characters went on, working with Stuart Hall, who directed it, and 4 and 5 working with Ed Freeman, they've been my favourite directors. So when you get a good director, it makes the experience so much better than if you work with someone you don't really like. So it's we're very lucky. Yeah, those are my favourite episodes.
Okay, we have a question from the young man here.
Hello. Do you like anime? Which one is your favourite, if you have one?
Yeah, I do quite like it. I haven't seen a lot though. I've seen I quite like Howl's Moving Castle. It's really good. And I know everyone likes Spirited Away, but it was good as well. Yeah.
What Colin said.
Okay, I have a question for this young lady.
Hey, it's for Colin and Bradley. The last year we came and we gave you a piece of cardboard that said we love you, and so you take a picture of us. And I don't know if you remember, but do you still have the cardboard?
Yes. We split it in two and cut it.
Right, okay, the next question. Hopefully nothing to do with the cardboard. Right, okay, let's pop them up down here.
I have two questions, one of which is really quick and really, really nerdy, and it's for Katie. There's a little 30-second clip in the first DVD extras, and you're filming the first beast scene in the first episode, and you're hanging around between takes with Bradley, and you're holding a toy tiger. And inquiring minds would like to know why that is, because there's been some discussion on the internet.
I would like to point out it's not me being weird with a teddy bear, it's a hot water bottle. Thanks, Hugo, though, he does have a name, but those costumes, you can't wear a lot under them or over them, so it gets quite cold, so the costume department very nicely gave me my own stuffed hot water bottle teddy bear named Hugo.
The main thing for us, and it's interesting you picked up on that point, is that the friendship between Morgana and Gwen becomes a lot closer in series two, and there are certain things that happens to Morgana's character where she needs her friend and somebody to talk to, and both Merlin and Gwen become her confidants in a way. So it is important for us that we keep that friendship going. But like all friendships, it in series two has moments of where that friendship is absolutely tested, and both of those characters begin.